Hello everyone. So when we started analytics in our company and my boss got all those fancy click dashboards to see all the data and so on from all the systems, he was very excited and started to send emails to the employees. Look at the status of a project, it's not completed. Look at the timing of a project, it's not good. And so on and so on. And, of course, eventually he got tired of this. He sees the data on the Click application, on our data analytics application, but only he can see the data because, you know, all the reports and so on, some sensitive data and so on, so it's not good to show it to the employees. Then we gave the access to some data to employees as well. They could see it. Did they look at it? No, they didn't look at it. They could see it, but they didn't look at the data. And my boss, of course, after some time got pissed. He is seeing the data, he's seeing that something is not right, and nobody cares about that. They can see the data, but they do not care about it. And that was not good. So we decided to start sending automated email reports. That's quite obvious. You'll get an email on Friday, let's say evening, about upcoming week, about acceptances, about expenses of the projects, about the status, and timesheet and some or any other data we would want and the boss would want to see. So, in this video, I will show you how to make automated emails using SQL, Microsoft SQL Express version of the database. First thing you would need to do, you have to create a profile from which you could send the emails. I already have it on my screen. This is like a script to do that. So you can see the script. I'm not typing it by hand because, well, I already have it. So basically what you want to do is to execute sysmail add account sp and add the details about your profile. Account name, you can call it anyway, I called it emails. You will use it all the time when you want to send the email. So it's better to have a short and the one that you could remember easily. Description, well, this can stay as it is. Email address, so the email from which emails will be sent. For that one, obviously, you have to have an email address which you could use to send the emails. I would recommend you to have a dedicated email address, not the one that's being used for some other purposes. Next, display name. So you can leave it the same or you can make it different. It doesn't matter. This is the one that people see near the email address. Username. This is for the email server. Usually it's the same as the email. Then, of course, the password and email server. We're using Microsoft Office 365, so this is the name of their server and the port of their server. But of course, if you're using some different provider, it will be different. And SSL, well, I would recommend you to enable it, but it depends on your email server, of course. Next thing, you'll have to execute another script, add a profile for the email sending. So profile name and description. But that's not all. We have to add profile account, and this is basically just the name of our profile we have typed earlier. At the end, we would need to add principal profile. So this is very similar to this one, but it's also required to be added. And of course, you can make it public or private. I would recommend you to make it private. So this is the basic script from which you could send the emails. What you have to do next? You have to run this script. Well, I already ran this on my server, so I'm just gonna go to the next thing, send the email. Let's open this table from our database, and we have some information in here. And let's say we want to send where we have some kind of sum. Okay, I can see it here. Let's say we want to send amount of this column through our newly created email profile. Let's delete the others. We don't need them for now. Of course, we want to have a sum of this. Here you go. Here is the sum. First thing, what you'll have to do if you want to send the email, you have to format everything that database would understand that you want to send this value with your emails. You'll have to declare some kind of value. So let's say declare, let's change this one to declare sum. And I would recommend you to use this one. Here is going to be just a number, so it won't be long and there won't be many digits, but if you want to send whole table, I would recommend you to keep it an varchar max, maximum value, because if you type some kind of digit and your data would have more digits, you would get an error. Once we have declared this value, we have to set this value, and we're gonna do this for our newly created SQL script. But before we can send the data, we have to convert it to the text, because in the email, well, it has to understand that this is some kind of text you are sending, not the data digits from the server. So yes, it's gonna be a digits, but we have to convert it to the text. We have to add the cast and type the same formatting as it was before. So it's, let's keep the same and varchar max. And now we can see that there are, well, at least looks like there are no errors. Let's execute. Here we go. Command was completed successfully. That's a good sign. That means that we have our value set up for this name, sum1. And now we want to send that value through the email. A little bit more of scripting and we should get it. And we're gonna send the email through the profile, well, I have created before. So first, of course, profile name, we have to type the name we have created before. Then recipients, you can type one or let's say more. Subject, obviously, all emails has to have a subject because otherwise it's gonna be a mess. Body, sum one. So this is the sum one we have created, and format HTML. We just got an email, the one that I sent. And you can see this is the sum. Of course, we can double check on that. We can run this one and see if it's the same. And of course, we have a mail ID was queened and time when it was completed. Let's execute this one. 1439. Well, that's a big number, but looks like it's the same. Yes, looks like this is the same. And we just got the email. But obviously, you don't want to send just an email. You want to send email with some more data, at least text describing what kind of this huge number it is. So let's add some text. To add some text before the number we're gonna send to our employees or some other person, we have to type capital N. It stands for N varchar, then semicolon, sample text. Here, very important data. Now that symbol again, and we have to add a plus symbol so that system would know that next goes the number. First goes text, then goes the number. And let's try to send it again. We just got another email. Here you go. The same text I just typed. Sample text, very important data in here. So this way you can add as many lines as you want. Press enter, declare some kind of, or add some kind of other SQL scripts. Now what to do if you want to send whole table, not just some kind of one digit, two digits, or three digits? Well, with a table, It's a little bit more tricky, but let's try to do it. It's not that hard when you know what to type. So, of course, first we want to have a script showing the data for the table. Okay, let's take, for example, this table. Let's select. Well, this one is a huge as well. Let's make it smaller. We don't want this huge table for now. Let's leave, let's say, 3 columns. Yeah, and let's leave, let's say, 10 lines for now. Let's execute. So we have some kind of data we want to send to our employees. Another value. Let's call it table. And let's make it an varchar max again. Because, like I said before, there might be more than 10 lines in your table. Let's type set. Let's copy paste our name of the variable. And now here's the a little bit more tricky part, but just a little bit, because you have to type something more, some like table columns names and so on. But trust me, it's not that hard. So first, of course, we want to tell the server that this is gonna be a table. So beginning is the same as for the sample text in here. We have to describe that this is an varchar, and let's add the first parameter table border. For this case, let's leave it 1. Of course, at the end plus sign, then we'll have to type the names of the columns. Let's press enter. Once we have our script, we have to tell that this is the table and that it has to have a different names, I mean the column names, and for which column which value goes to. Because when there is a table, well, we type the names in here, but we have to give each column a value that system would know for which column which value goes to. To do that, we have to add td and then, of course, the space so that it would go to the next column. These two brackets are most important. And let's do this for the other columns. Of course, we can delete this one at the end because we have it here. So again, let's paste it at the beginning of each column. And yes. So this way, the system will know for which column which data has to be applied. Yes, that's very important. And now, as you can see, everything looks more or less fine. But it's not fine yet, because we have opened the table in here, like with this symbol, and of course we have to close the table. Once we add the script, we have to add the ending of the script, and it's going to be slightly different than we had before. So we have to describe that this is XML, as this is a table. Then we have to type a TR, because we have started the table in here, so we have to close the table. And again, as nvarchar max. And of course, close the table itself, as we have started it here. One more thing that I think I missed before. So we have to type the cast at the front. So we would have cast and all the other data. So let's select it. Let's run it. Looks good. No error messages in here. Let's try to send the email. Yeah, so now just not select everything and let's press execute. Did you just hear? Email just arrived. Let's check it out. And we have the same email again. Why do we have the same email again? Because we did not change the profile from which email should be sent. As you can see, we have someone here, and of course, this is a table, not someone here. So let's change it to the table and let's send the email again. Here you go. Here is the table we have just created and the data from the table. So this way you'll be able to send your emails to your employees as much as you want. If you're using a SQL Express version, you'll have to create a shared procedure, stored procedure, and then use a Windows Task Manager to run that procedure. But let's leave this for the next time. I think the video will be somewhere here, around here, and you can see it. So, thank you for watching. If you like the video, please like it. If you don't, well, dislike it. Leave your comments, subscribe the channel if you like what I'm doing, and of course, check my Patreon account. You will see that script in there, so you don't have to copy it from the video, which is much easier, right? Okay, see you next time. Repeat. Did you just get... Let's make it smaller. We don't. That camera. You should not stop recording. You should not do that. God fucking damn it. Some kind of children is screaming outside the window. I hope they will stop. I don't want any screaming children in my videos. That's for sure.